Hello, comic comrades! Did you see Eternals? I hope you did, because I'm going to tell you all about their bosses, the Celestials. Stay tuned until the end of the video, and don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe, and click that notification bell. As the creators of the Eternals, the Celestials must be incredibly powerful, but what can they do, really?
Fine. I'll do it myself.
First briefly depicted in James Gunn's Guardians of the Galaxy, the mysterious and ancient space gods have a quiet and mysterious presence in the MCU thus far. Like their comic book counterparts, the Celestials are towering cosmic beings that dwell deep in outer space. Based on what we know about the MCU Celestials, all signs point to them being comparable to the comic versions in regards to their powers. Both are seen as godlike entities that are responsible for creating the Eternals, and in the comics are responsible for helping to bring about the multiverse itself. On top of possessing tremendous strength and cosmic power, the MCU Celestials boast a number of abilities. Jemiah the Analyzer can be seen teleporting and generating a collection of energy in his hands for an unknown purpose. And since they are the same race as Ego, the living planet, it's plausible that at least some of them share his skill set. Ego could control quote-unquote light energy and project it into devastating blasts against his enemies. In addition, he could manipulate matter, giving him the ability to mentally repair injuries to his body and create a human form that he could assume at will. But I digress, let me tell you who the most powerful Celestials actually are. Number 10. Nowhere. Of course he's number 10. He is a deadhead. Nowhere is the severed head of a deceased celestial avatar, home of the mining colony of Exitar. Hundreds of years ago, the Tivan group set up mining operations in the decapitated head of the celestial avatar in order to harvest the valuable bone, brain tissue, and spinal fluid from it. The absence of rules and regulations turned Nowhere into a safe haven for outlaws from across the galaxy. Nowhere acts as a makeshift port of call and observatory of the end of the universe for intergalactic travelers of all species and all forms. The origins of Nowhere are uncertain. It is unknown as to how the severed head of a celestial would have appeared at the end of the universe, and what kind of forces could conceivably decapitate the godlike alien. In the comics, while recounting his origin to Eddie Brock, the symbiote god Null revealed that he was the one who killed the celestial whose head became Nowhere, with the use of All Black, the Necro Sword, and used his head to create more symbiotes. Maybe when Venom becomes part of the MCU, we'll see those epic events in a movie. Number 9. Star-Lord. He was kind of a half-celestial, and he is still alive, so he ranks higher than a floating head in space. Star-Lord never got to unleash his full powers when they were activated in Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2, but it was a testament to how powerful he was that he brought Ego to a stalemate, although he did have help. He showed the ability to manipulate energy out of nothing and could make it do whatever he wanted. Star-Lord also displayed powers of shapeshifting and power summoning when he turned himself into an enormous Pac-Man. He most likely would have had the same powers as Ego, but we'll never know. As his powers didn't last long, he can't be placed higher up in this list. Number 8. Jemiah the Analyzer. He first appeared in the Eternals issue 7 comic in 1976, created by Jack Kirby. We don't know the exact moment of his birth, but we know that he was there even before the first host or the first visit of the Celestials to Earth. Jemiah was a member of the first host, where Celestials arrived on Earth around 1 million years ago. They started experimenting on human ancestors after deeming other life forms on Earth unworthy. They have done the same thing on many planets, creating Eternals and deviants from lower life forms. On top of that, he observes the activities and progress of a civilization and reports the results of his analysis to the leader, Arishem the Judge. Apart from having a brilliant mind and the ability for unmistakable analysis, Jemiah the Analyzer has all the powers and abilities that the celestial race possesses by default. When Arishem showed Cersei the true purpose of the Eternals, he showed himself, Jemiah, and other Celestials creating stars. Number 7. Nazar the Calculator. A character created by Jack Kirby, first appearing in Eternals issue 9 in 1976, Nazar is a Celestial responsible for the creation of the universe itself. Nazar's powers lie in his name. He's the Calculator, a mathematician of incredible intelligence who explores possibilities and variables to help determine a planet's fate. He doesn't have the final say, though. Arishem the Judge decides whether to destroy or preserve a planet. In the MCU, when Arishem revealed the true purpose of the Eternals to new Prime Cersei, they observed Celestials at work. Nazar was one of the ancient beings shown. Number 6. Hagen the Measurer. Born eons ago when the universe was young, Hagen the Measurer was tasked, like all the other Celestials, with a specific duty that he would have fulfilled for the entirety of his eternal existence by the Fulcrum, the embodiment of the balance of universes, forces, and energies. Part of the host of Arishem the Judge, Hagen visited countless planets, measuring their mountains and their oceans, their extension and their atmosphere, collecting data on the evolution of the planet itself rather than on its populations. Also, his work was considered fundamental for determining the existence of sentient species, as the way Eternals, Deviants, and whatever was in between affected the environment with the progress of their respective societies. And Hagen's measurements were pivotal in assessing the level of development of a planet's races. When Arishem explained the true purpose of the Eternals to the new Prime Eternal Circe, he showed her imagery of the Celestials creating suns, Hagen among them. Number 5. Eson the Searcher. Eson is a giant celestial being that once held one of the six Infinity Stones, specifically the Power Stone. As many fans will know, the Infinity Stones can only be wielded by those with immense power. With Eson being a celestial, he was strong enough to use the Power Stone and leveled out the surface of an entire planet, vaporizing every living thing in his path. Similar to Thanos, Eson is ruthless with little regard for anybody who gets in his way. His powers came from his celestial race, meaning he is able to manipulate and create matter on a molecule level. Plus, Eson is large and physically strong, making him a force to be reckoned with. Although he's similar to Thanos in terms of personal attributes, it must be noted that Eson is far stronger than any other being featured in the Marvel Cinematic Universe so far, even Thanos. He is one of the strongest villains in the entire universe. Eson made his cinematic debut very briefly in the Guardians of the Galaxy as part of a flashback. Number 4. The Phoenix Force. I know this is kind of a cheat, but a Celestial, by definition, is any life form that achieved sentience during the earliest phases of the universe. They should also have the ability to manipulate cosmic energy at a grand scale. The Phoenix Force meets these criteria and is thus considered a Celestial, and we know how much they change in the MCU. Eagle was not even one in the comics. While there have been many versions of the Phoenix Force, we will consider the Jean Grey version. Her telepathic and telekinetic powers, combined with her Phoenix Force abilities, made her a true force of nature. She even went up against a Celestial only to lose at the end. Be that as it may, she is still immensely powerful, and only a true battle-tested Celestial being could harm her. And I can't wait to see the adaptation of Avengers vs. X-Men in Phase 15 of the MCU. Number 3. Tiamat the Communicator. The character Tiamat is the baby Celestial embedded deep within the Earth and hoping to emerge. He uses energy from the planet's enormous population of intelligent life, humans, and then begins tearing his way out of the planet near a volcano. However, only his head and hand emerge before Circe transmutes him into stone, forever freezing him in place like a wanderer unlucky enough to come upon Medusa. And that's that as far as the MCU goes. However, in Neil Gaiman's Eternals Volume 3, Tiamat is also known as the Dreaming Celestial, one of the most powerful of all Celestials. Long ago, he had a conflict with Arishem and the other Celestials, so they imprisoned him under a mountain range on Earth. Then, in the comics' modern times, the Deviants decide to wake him up, worrying the Eternals, who are concerned this would destroy Earth. Heck, even Galactus, the Devourer of Worlds, aka a much larger and much more powerful purple guy than Thanos, is afraid when Tiamat begins to awaken. Unlike the movie, though, Tiamat emerges right next to San Francisco. He communicates with Makari, and the Eternals learn that something called the Horde is coming to kill everyone on Earth. Much like Arishem in the movie, he decides he will judge whether or not humanity can continue living. As the story continues in Eternals Volume 4, he grows to care for humans and wants them to live. So, not such a bad guy after all. Number 2. Ego, the Living Planet. While Ego did lose his life to the Guardians of the Galaxy, he's the one with the most known feats out of all the Celestials. He also only lost because the Guardians outnumbered him and had to go for his weak point rather than beat him fair and square. Ego had the power to assimilate full worlds into himself. He could have remade everything in the universe the way he wanted, with his planet being proof of what he was capable of. He seemed to be as old as time itself and had visited the farthest reaches of space. It's unlikely he would have even been affected by Thanos' snap, considering the scale of his powers. Number 1. Arishem the Judge. In the comics, Arishem the Judge is basically the highest ranking of all the Celestials that are involved with anything Earth-related, and a pretty big shot among the Celestial ranks in general. In fact, he is one of the two members of his species who may decide whether civilizations survive or fall, which effectively gives him the ability to rain destruction on a planetary scale, as befits his cheerful moniker, Killer of Planets. The MCU version clearly retains the judging tendencies of the comics Arishem, and while his exact powers are still somewhat up in the air, it's highly likely that the Celestial leader is significantly stronger than the other prominent MCU member of the species, Ego. Considering that the latter outright states that he's able to spread his influence across space with the aid of another Celestial, or for that matter a Celestial hybrid, this means Arishem is pretty surely one of the most powerful entities in the MCU. So, those were some powerful beings. Except the Deadhead and Star-Lord, of course. But tell me, who is your favorite Celestial? What other Celestials from the comics you want in the MCU? Share your thoughts with me in the comments below, and don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe, and rank that notification bell number 1. Peace out!